Foreign direct investment inflows to the Philippines plunged in 2020 due to weak business environment caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. But as Warren de Guzman tells us, the country's elevated inflation could further turn off foreign businesses from setting up shop here in the country.
Foreign direct investment inflows to the Philippines nosedived in 2020. From $8.7 billion in 2019, it fell nearly 25% to $6.5 billion last year. 2020 was also the third straight year FDI inflows have gone down for the Philippines after it peaked at a record high of over $10 billion in 2017. New investments, reinvestments, and debt placements were all down year on year, and most countries ended up investing less in the Philippines compared to 2019. Among the top sources of new foreign investment inflows, the Japanese were the only ones to actually increase new investments into the Philippines. China is sixth on the list, despite President Rodrigo Duterte's charm offensive on Beijing. Philippine Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno is quick to point out the plunge in FDI in 2020 was not unique to the Philippines. Data collected by the Asian Development Bank show FDI inflows into Asia, particularly for greenfield or new projects in energy and tourism, contracted sharply in 2020. Mergers and acquisitions also contracted early last year before depressed valuations in capital markets helped spark new M&As in food and beverage and communication. Elevated inflation, however, could also turn off investors. Analysts from S&P Global Ratings note an extended period of high inflation could hamper a key economic engine of the Philippines, consumer spending. Jokno notes that their own inflation forecasts show inflation has yet to peak this year.
Inflation is projected to rise above the high end of the target range in the first half of 2021, with a peak expected in the second quarter, due to the transitory impact of supply-side price pressures as well as positive base effects. Inflation is then seen to decelerate below the midpoint of the target range by the fourth quarter of this year and in Q1 2022 due to negative base effects, before settling closely to the midpoint by the second half of 2022.
Jokno also notes inflation is only being pushed by transitory or temporary supply issues with key food items such as pork, and the national government is working to address these with multiple programs, including a 600 million peso plan to repopulate hog farms in African swine fever-free areas and the importation of more pork meat. Jokno adds the Philippine Central Bank's own performance as an inflation gatekeeper is actually a good reason for investors to choose the Philippines.
We have demonstrated over the years that we are very good in our inflation targeting. As I said, the inflation expectations remain well anchored. We expect inflation to be within at least the upper bound this year, and then to about 2.7 or below 3% next year. And in fact, our forecast for 2023 to 2024, if I remember right, is that we will still be within the 2 to 4% growth target. So to my mind, if you're a long-term investor, you will be looking at long-term prospects. And the long-term prospects of the Philippines are pretty good at this time, despite the pandemic.
Other reasons for investors to come to the Philippines include a projected strong rebound in economic growth following the 2020 recession, and the CREATE law, which cuts corporate income taxes and introduces a new menu of fiscal incentives to woo offshore investors. On the flip side, investors are holding on to their cash because of the recent surge in new COVID-19 cases, which could force tighter lockdowns and choke off the economic recovery, complex legal restrictions on foreign ownership and investment, and low yields stemming from the Philippine Central Bank's record low interest rates. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.